Hello friends, so today we will be discussing the chapter, the second part of the chapter of solution. So in this chapter, we will be discussing what is an emulsion. Okay, we will also be looking at the dissolution of small ions, molecules and macromolecules in water. Solubility of solids and gases in liquid. Okay, so we will be going through the solubility curve as well. So herein, the first thing we will be talking about, what is emulsion. So emulsion. So emulsion is, I told you earlier, emulsion, it is a colloid. It is a colloid of liquid in liquid where one of the liquid is water and the other is oil. So it is mostly oil in water or water in oil format. Okay, so there are two types. So what are the types? The types are either it is oil in water, otherwise it is water in water. Okay, oil in water and water in oil. When I say oil in water, then the dispersed free is oil and dispersion medium is water. Here dispersed phase, if I talk about the dispersed phase, in this case, here I have the dispersed phase as oil and dispersion medium as water. Okay, as water. Fine. So here this is the case, whereas if I say in water in oil, then what is the process? Here the dispersed phase is water and dispersion medium is oil. Dispersion medium is oil. Okay. So, this is the difference between both. Okay. Next. So, what are the examples? So, when I have oil in water, what is the example that I have? Here, the example would be oil in water. The examples are basically your milk, wherein the tiny droplets of liquid fat are dispersed in water and season is an emulsifier. I will tell you what is an emulsifier a bit later. Okay. And when I say water in oil, here I have the example as our very, very favorite butter. Okay. So here this is the example. Okay. Now when we prepare emulsions using water, oil, and soap. We are using water, oil, and soap. So what happens is dispersion of a liquid in the form of an emulsion is emulsification. Emulsions are prepared by agitating small portions of one liquid with a bulk of others. This is done by passing a mixture of two liquids to a colloidal milk called homogenizer. The emulsions prepared by shaking the two liquids are not stable. To stabilize, there is a third component that is being used, that is called as emulsifier, which is required in a very small amount during the preparation. And common agents are soap, detergents, gum, gelatin, etc. So whenever we come ahead with this emulsion, we have we are coming across few definitions. One is emulsification. What is emulsification? Emulsification, which is the process of dispersion of liquid in the form of emulsion. The process of dispersion of liquid in the form of emulsion. Okay? In the form of emulsion. Fine? So this is emulsification. Emulsification is the process. And next, we will come across what is emulsifier. Emulsifier is the component that is added in a small amount to stabilize the emulsion. Example could easily be soap. Okay, example could easily be soap. Right? Okay. Now, so we understood what is emulsification. We understood what is an emulsifier. Okay. Now, what is the importance of emulsion? Milk, cream, butter, these are all emulsions, are important constituents of our food. And various cosmetic cold creams, body lotions are also emulsions. So in the form of cosmetics or in the form of food, emulsions are very much required. How do we prepare an emulsion? So you have some oil, you have some distilled water, and what you can do is dissolve this bee wax in mineral oil and heat it. And slowly add small amount of water with constant stirring. And you will stop heating and continue stirring until the temperature of the resulting steam becomes 25 degrees Celsius. That is how you prepare an emulsion. Okay. So you can use any number of, you can use coconut oil, soap solution and distilled water wherein you will add coconut oil, then after that you will keep on adding distilled water. You add coconut oil and soap solution, then after that keep on adding distilled water and go on mixing it. You will again get a emulsion. Fine. That is how your cream is being prepared or lotions are being prepared. Okay. Now, next is preparation of colloidal sulfur. How will you prepare colloidal sulfur from sodium thiosulfate? A concentrated solution of sodium thiosulfate is prepared. The solution is then acidified with sulfuric acid. Milky sulfur is liberated. These liberated sulfur cannot be separated by filtration. Remain suspended as colloid. Now, what is the use of emulsifiers in daily life? So in everyday life, what is the use of emulsifiers? Some hydrophilic colloids are added in small amounts to colloidal system or emulsions to stabilize and protect their colloidal nature. First is in ice cream. So if I say use of emulsifiers, so emulsifiers, I have first one is in ice cream. In ice cream industries, it is very much being used. There's a gelatin which is added to protect the colloid to give smooth taste. The texture is very smooth. The little amount of gelatin prevents ice cream from forming gritty crystals of ice and lactose. Again, in gum arabic is added to certain inks to stabilize. So in inks also, what is being added is gum arabic. Okay. And in ice cream, what is being added is gelatin. Fine. Okay, next. After this, the colloidal dispersion of silver bromide used in preparation of photographic film is stabilized by adding gelatin. Again, photographic film. Photographic film. Here also you use gelatin. Fine. Next. Fourth one. Emulsion paints are stabilized by adding the emulsifier tetrasodium pyrophosphate, sodium lauryl phosphate, etc. So in paints also they have been using emulsifier. Okay, now the next thing we will go ahead with the dissolution of small ions or molecules and macromolecules in water. So dissolution of small ions, molecules and macromolecules. Fine. This is the next topic we will be going ahead with. Fine. Okay. Herein, in the case of dissolution, a solution is formed by physical process, like by solvent action of the solvent on the solute. Generally, no chemical reaction takes place, as we have seen earlier. Okay. In water, generally ionic compounds like sodium chloride, potassium sulfate, calcium chloride, etc. Mineral acids like hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, or alkalis like NaOH, KOH, organic acids like formic acid, acetic acid. And some organic compounds like alcohol, urea, and sugars are soluble. So in water, there are few components which are soluble. The small ions form ionic compounds, and some molecules which are attracted by the water molecules are stabilized by interaction between water molecules and are soluble in water. So there is an interaction between the ions and the, so there is an interaction of ions with water molecules. There is no combination. There is only an interaction. That is why it is a mixture. There is no combination or there is no reaction. These will lead to the formation of solution. Okay. Now, some organic compounds are also attracted by water molecules. They are hydrated ions and molecules having very small size. They enter into the intermolecular space of water to give homogeneous mixture. Or through solution. Or what happens is either it goes ahead with the interaction of ions. Otherwise, what happens is there can also be see the screen, and here it is. So I said you, whenever there is a solution, so there are in various formats, either the ions are forming interactions with the water molecules. Second is the organic compounds. How are the organic compounds getting dissolved? Organic compounds, they take up or they fill up the intermolecular spaces. They fill up the intermolecular spaces. So, say there is a water molecule. I will say, for example, there is a water molecule over here. Similarly, there is another water molecule. Okay. And there is another water molecule over here. So, this space in between, space in between this is called as a void. This is called as a void. This position in this place, this is what I call it as a void. This is the point. So what will happen for my organic molecule will come and fill up this void. There might be an organic molecule. Let me take a different shape of my organic molecule. Let it be rectangular in shape, and then it will fill up this area. Different colors here so that it will be able to understand that much better. Let me fill this. So here is my organic molecule. They will enter into the intermolecular space. Okay. Next, after that, the macromolecules are hydrophilic colloids. The particles of these macromolecules having the size of colloidal particles. These molecules are shielded by water molecules and a slit line. These macromolecules are larger and cannot enter into the intermolecular space. So they remain in dispersion medium water by displacing large number of water molecules. So what happens? In case of my macromolecules. Now, macromolecules are larger in shape, so they will not be able to take up the place in the void. So they are much larger. So what they will do? They will instead replace some of my water molecules. They will replace some of my water molecules, and here they will take up the position. Here they will, the macromolecule will take up the position over here. Okay, the green color. Fine? Alright. So that says how the dissolution of small ions, molecules and macromolecules happens in water. Okay, next. We are coming on to the solubility of solid gases and liquids. So we are coming into solubility of solid, liquid, and gas. Solid, liquid, and gas. Fine? Okay. Alright. So, in this portion, what are we going to learn? Here, we are going to start our learning with a small mathematical equation. There's nothing to worry about. Okay. So, whenever we talk about solubility, solubility is nothing but the weight of the solvent by the weight of the solute by weight of the solvent. So, I will write it in this format. Here is weight of the solute divided by weight of the solvent. Okay, and it is always in percentage. So I will have into 100. This is what is my solubility. This is the formula for my solubility. Okay. Weight of solute by weight of solvent into 100. Okay. Both are in grams, so solubility will have no unit. Now, what is the effect of pressure and temperature on the solubility of gases in liquid? So, effect of pressure at there is an increase in the pressure, the surface of water, it increases the solubility. Okay. Like in soda water, what happens? Carbon dioxide is dissolved at higher pressure than normal pressure. Solubility of carbon dioxide increases with increasing pressure in the solution. On opening the lid of soda water bottle, what happens? It dissolves the gas at high pressure, rapidly bubbles out. Because of an opening the lid, the pressure of the solution suddenly increases. Okay. So, what happens in gas and liquid? So, okay, fine. So, I was talking to you about the solubility, the effects of temperature and pressure. Effects, so when a gas is dissolved in liquid, what happens? Effects of pressure. Effect of pressure is proportional. I can say proportional because as one increases, other also increases. Fine. So that is proportional. If the pressure increases, the solubility also increases. Okay. Now, there is a very little effect of pressure on dissolution of solids. So, in case of solids, this is not happening. So, not a solid. Fine. Next, what is the effect of temperature? Effect of temperature. In this case, if there is an increase of temperature of water, it causes decrease of solubility. So, this inversely proportional. Inversely proportional. Okay, fine. So, if there is an increase, so gases are more soluble in cold water than at higher temperature. Boiling water loses its taste because the taste of water due to dissolved gases in it on boiling, these gases are going to escape, and so there is a tastelessness of boiled water. And in case of solids, this is proportional. In case of solids, it is proportional. Again, if it increases, there is an increase in solubility in solid. Okay. So this is how the effect of temperature and pressure on solubility of gases in liquid, or otherwise I can say solids and liquids in liquids as well. Okay. Generally, solubility of solids increases with increase of temperature. What are the factors affecting solubility? The rate of solubility of solids in water depends on the following factors. One is, so if I say that, what are the factors affecting the solubility? One is that we said, obviously the particle size, the lesser. Stirring the mixture, how well do you stir it? How rapidly do you stir it? That also will affect the solubility. Okay, if you stir it very rapidly, there is a formation of a better solution. It brings more solvent in contact with the solute and increases the solubility. Then the next is temperature. Temperature, the solubility of gas and liquid decreases with rising temperature, but solubility of most of the solids in water usually increases with rising temperature. For solids, it's proportional. Whereas for gases, it is inversely. Okay, inversely proportional. Next, we will come ahead with the solubility curve. Now we will come to solubility curve. Solubility curve. So what is a solubility curve? A solubility curve is a line graph obtained by showing the effect of temperature on solubility. Okay, so it is a line graph. Obtained. How is it obtained? It is obtained showing the effect of temperature on solubility. Temperature on solubility. So you will find the same thing let me take for an example, I am having a graph, and say this is a graph that I have, and I am having solubility of different components. Okay, I am having a solubility of different components. Some it is increasing, some it is decreasing. Fine. So I have my potassium nitrate would go in this manner. So it is going in some manner like this. Okay, so I have my potassium nitrate which goes in this manner. So let me give these different colors so that you can understand. So if I give it a different color, okay, let my potassium nitrate be blue in color. Fine. And I will have my I will have my curve of sodium chloride, which is almost, it is a very much a straight line, as it is an ionic compound. It is a very much straight line. So let my sodium chloride be somewhere in red color, so that it is very much visible. And I will also have one of the other, that is calcium hydroxide, as it is given. I will also take one example of calcium hydroxide. So let me see if I can work this out. So fine. Working this way, so I should try to manipulate this. So basically, my calcium hydroxide is having a very smooth curve. So I'm unable to show it over here. Okay, unable to show it. So what happens in potassium nitrate, which is in my blue color, it shows considerable increase of solubility with increase of temperature, whereas sodium chloride, my red color line, there is an increase with increasing temperature. Fine. So even calcium hydroxide, it would have increased earlier and then after the decrease. So this is my solubility curve, fine. So now what is my application of solubility curve that I have? So I can always predict how the solubility of substance in a solvent varies with temperature. And also I can also understand the solubilities of different solute in different solvents in a solvent. How is my solubility of different solutes in a solvent at different temperatures? So that is in this video. Next video we will discuss about the unsaturated, saturated and supersaturated solutions, and also the portion of the motion that is happening in a solution.